Last Sunday we focused on John chapter 10 verses 9 and 10. And it stated, I am the gate, whoever enters through me will be saved. He will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal, kill, and destroy. I have come that you may have life and have it to the full. Last Sunday, the challenge was placed before us that we should commit ourselves to Jesus. Jesus is the source of life and life abundantly. We should hand over control of our lives to Jesus. If we choose Jesus, we find safety. If we choose Jesus, we find provisions. With Jesus, we have a leader, we have a protector, and we find an identity. What is your identity in Christ? And that is what I want to delve this morning. What is our identity in Christ if we chose Him as our Savior, as our friend? 1 Peter chapter 2 helps us to answer this question about identity. 1 Peter chapter 2 gives us a glimpse of who we are in Christ. So firstly, Peter states that we need to know that all children want to grow. One of the things that happen in my house sometimes is Jessica comes into the room and she says, Mommy, Daddy, Hannah says I'm a baby. She doesn't want to be the baby. She wants to be big. And as children of God, that should also be our heart's desire. We need to want to grow. We need to want to desire to grow. We need spiritual milk. And this milk is found in Scripture. So Peter emphasizes the fact that as children of God, we need to desire for this spiritual milk, this milk that will help us grow. We need God's word to grow. Are you spending enough time reading the Bible so that you can grow and mature in Christ? Secondly, Peter states that we are living stones. Together, all these living stones come together to build the church. Christ being the cornerstone, you and I, stones in this church, this body of Christ. On our own, we are not the church. On my own, I am not the church. But together, we are the church. Together, we form the church. In short, Peter brings across the idea that I need you, and you need me, and we need Christ. As this community, the church can stand strong, and the church can grow. We as a church need to work together. Together, we can achieve much. We can't just sit back and say they will do it, or they are doing it. No, we need to come together and say we will do it. Together we are the church. Peter says that we are living stones and together with Christ we form, we build the church. Thirdly, Peter states that we are a priesthood that are called to offer spiritual sacrifices to God. The Life Application Bible argues that God wants us to offer ourselves as living spiritual sacrifices to Him. Daily laying aside our own desires and following Him. Daily putting all our energy and resources at His disposal and trusting Him to guide us. Basically, we are called to walk in obedience to God. We are called to pray, not my will, Lord, but your will be done through me. Peter says, we are to offer spiritual sacrifices to God. You and I, a sacrifice to God. Lastly, Peter says to you and me, you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people belonging to God. You are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people belonging to God. Notice who you are. You are chosen. You are a chosen people. You are a royal priesthood. You are holy, a holy nation. And above all this, you and I, we are a people belonging to God. In the strange world that we live in this world filled with challenges, filled with dangers, remember who you are. Remember who you are. And above all, remember whose you are. I want to challenge you to remember who you are in Christ. And remember that you are in Christ. Listen to what Jesus says to his disciples. John chapter 14, verse 1. Don't let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me. Don't let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me. The author Max Lucado, in a book that he wrote called He Chose the Nails, wrote, what do we do with these worries? What do you and I do with these worries? He continues to say, take your anxieties to the cross, literally. Next time you worried about your health or your home or your finances or flights, take a mental trip up the hill. See the blood he bled for you, the spear he took for you, the nails he felt for you. He did all this for you. Knowing this, knowing all he did for you there, don't you think he'll look out for you here? Don't you think he'll look out for you here? Do yourself a favor. Max Lucado carries on. Do yourself a favor. Take your anxious moments to the cross. Leave them there with your bad moments, your mad moments, and your anxious moments. Jesus calls us to trust God and to trust in him. So we come to him in prayer and leave our worries and concerns with him. He lifts the weights off our shoulders and he releases us from all our care, all our worry, all our anxious thoughts. We just need to come and leave it with him. Also remember that you and I, Peter says, we are a royal priesthood. You are a priest of God. I am a priest of God. Remember God's word and speak the truth to yourself from God's word. Tell yourself the truths that are found in God's word. When you are scared, tell yourself, God hasn't given me a spirit of fear, according to 2 Timothy 1:7. Tell yourself, I can cast all my worries on him because he cares for me. 1 Peter 5:7. Tell yourself, Jesus said, in this world we have troubles, but take heart, I have overcome the world. John 16, verse 33. And here the psalmist telling us to tell ourselves, God is my refuge. Psalm 62, verse 7. Remember who you are in Christ. You are a preacher. Preach the word of God to yourself. Remind yourself what the word of God says. As we remind ourselves of his word, our focus shifts from our worries to our God. Our focus shifts from our worries to our Father, and praise starts to fill our heart. Our God and Father is far greater than our problems. Someone once said, maybe we should stop telling God how big our problems are. Maybe we should try to stop telling our problems how big our God is. Lastly, hear Jesus say, I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Son may bring glory to the Father. You may ask me for anything in my name, and I will do it. The question that we need to answer is, are you and I willing to bring big asks before Jesus? Are you and I willing to bring big asks before Jesus? Caleb, my son, will come to me and he will say, Daddy, can I have 2 sweets, please? And I will say, yes, boy. And then he adds on to the 2 sweets. And can I have a piece of cake? And then I say, no. But chances are that if he asks in the first sentence, Daddy, can I have a piece of cake, please, and 2 sweets? Chances are that I would have said yes. But because he's not willing to make the big asks, he doesn't get what he really wants. And Jesus wants you and me to ask for anything in his name that is in his will, and he will do it. Are you willing to place the big asks before Jesus? So in conclusion, in Christ and through Christ, we find our true identity. We are children of God, and we must grow to spiritual maturity. Commit yourself to reading your Bible. We are living stones. Together with the cornerstone, we are the church. Let us commit ourselves to work together as the church and not be so organizational bound. The Mothers Union are doing this, the AWF are doing this, the men are doing this, but let us see it as the church. We are doing this together. We are an offering, a sacrifice to God. Let us die to self and live in obedience to him. And lastly, we are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people belonging to God. You and I, we belong to God. Let us hear God and live as people who belong to him. Let us hear Jesus and listen to him. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Let us walk in his truth. Let us walk in his way. Rejoice in his truth and share his risen life. Let us walk in his way. Rejoice in his truth and share his risen life. Amen.